listen, yeah, to your old stomping ground. Whoa, we'll knock three times, and if you don't hear a sound, you'll know where to find me. This one bar town.
He is the world's wealthiest hillbilly.
You know, ever since they struck gas and oil on my property, the neighbors have been fussing all over the place about how these waters all been messed up by the stuff the company squirts down there. Well, all I can tell them is it's like my grandma used to tell me, if life hands you something you wouldn't touch with a stick, bottle it up and sell it to the tourists.
In 1934, July of 1934, a group of sharecroppers and tenant farmers, both white and black, decided they'd had enough of the system of labor they were working under. They were had been oppressed for many, many years, and the New Deal seemed to only be making it worse. So they got together with the help of some socialists who were local to Arkansas, two young businessmen, and Norman Thomas, who was the perennial socialist presidential candidate, and they formed a union. The Southern Tenant Farmers Union. They formed it for one reason. They wanted control over their own lives. They wanted to be able to make their own economic decisions.
Hey, there was a socialist college in MENA in the 20s and 30s, and a guy painted this mural. Do you want it? Because it's lining this closet in a house in Fort Smith that's about to be torn down. So fragile, it's in 29 pieces, and really the paint is just chipping off kind of like cornflakes. In 2009, the St. Louis Art Museum contacted me and said, hey, do you have a mural by Joe Jones? And I said, yes. And they go, we want to exhibit it. We're doing a big show on him. And I said, you can't exhibit it. It's too fragile. And they said, we'll restore part of it at our expense. And they did.
My granddaddy used to walk the line. You never want to see my grandma cry. Gave up the booze and the late night boys. Then he shuffled out to church in his corduroys. Yeah, he shuffled out to church in his corduroys.